Good morning, students. How are you? I hope you all are fine. I'm also fine. This is another session of our learning. Today we are going to talk about market. When you go to market to buy a few things, we are going to look at those expressions. Au supermarché, at the supermarket. Nos objectifs sont les suivants. Lecture des dialogues. Indiquer ce qu'on veut acheter. Demander le prix de l'objet. Demander combien vous devez payer. Quelques aliments. La quantité. Exercice. So our lesson will be based on shopping at the supermarket. And the following are what we are going to do. Reading of dialogues. To indicate what you want to buy, you ask for the price. Then you ask how much you will pay for it. Then we also look at vocabulary on food items and also the quantity. Then it will be followed by an exercise. Let's continue. Lecture des dialogues. On a dialogue 1 et dialogue 2. Le dialogue 1, c'est entre Ampadu et Asabia. Et le dialogue 2 sera entre Sandra et Erika. Commençons donc par le dialogue numéro 1. We are going to read the dialogue number 1. Je veux acheter une boîte de Milo et 1 kg de sucre. C'est tout? Non. Je veux aussi du beurre et du pain sucré. Je paye combien, s'il vous plaît? Vous payez 70 cedis. Dialogue 2. Bonjour. Je veux un sac de riz, 5 litres d'huile, puis 2 kg de poulet, s'il vous plaît. Combien je vous paye? Vous payez 350 cedis. Je peux payer avec le Momo? Oui, madame. Momo, mon numéro est le 0244... So here is the dialogue between Ampadu and Asabia, where Ampadu goes to the supermarket to buy a tin of Milo with sugar and ask for the price. Then he had to pay in all 70 cedis. The second dialogue is between Sandra and Erika, where Sandra wants to buy a bag of rice, 5 liters of oil, with 2 kilos of chicken, and then she pays for it, which is about 350 cedis. Thank you, and let's use this dialogue now to derive our lesson, the content of our lesson. Indiquer ce qu'on veut acheter. How do you indicate what you want to buy? You say this. Je veux acheter plus objet. I want to buy plus the object or thing that you want to buy or the item you want to buy. So here we have the table present 3 columns. The first column is your intent to buy. Then the second column tells about the item that you want to buy. Then you add please to it. Example, je veux acheter des oranges, s'il vous plaît. If you consider the first line, je veux acheter des oranges, s'il vous plaît. So now let's go by column to learn how to read them. Please repeat after me. Je veux acheter, je veux, or donnez-moi. Des oranges, 2 kg de riz, de la salade, 1 kg de tomates, 1 kg de poulet, 1 kg de viande, 1 litre d'huile, 1 sachet de Milo, une boîte de lait, s'il vous plaît. So now you can make a sentence. For example, je veux acheter de la salade, s'il vous plaît. Donnez-moi 2 kg de riz, s'il vous plaît. So, based on the table, I make sentences, okay, which indicate what I want to buy. Demander le prix, to ask for the price of the item you want to buy. How do you go about it? You can say, objet coûte combien? This is a formula, so you indicate the item, then you add combien, coûte combien. For example, the bag of rice cost how much? Donc, le sac de riz coûte combien? Okay. Let's continue. Combien coûte plus objet? C'est combien plus objet? Donc l'objet indique ce que vous voulez acheter. Exemple. Un sac de riz coûte combien? Un spaghetti, un paquet de biscuits coûte combien? Combien coûte une boîte de lait? How much is a tin of milk? So this indicates how to ask the price. You indicate the item that you want to buy, then you add combien coûte. Or you can say combien coûte plus the item that you want to buy, or c'est combien plus the item that you want to buy. Example, un sac de riz coûte combien? How much is a bag of rice? Un paquet de biscuits coûte combien? How much is a packet of biscuits? Okay, let's continue. Demandez combien vous devez payer. To ask how much you are supposed to pay for the item. To ask how much you should pay for a commodity, use any of the following words. Ça fait combien? Je vous paye combien? Je paye combien? Which is, how much do I pay for it? Example, je vais acheter une boîte de lait, madame. Ça fait combien? And she responds, ça fait 12 cedis. Okay, I want to buy a tin of milk, madame. How much is it? It costs 12 cedis. Deux boîtes de sardines, s'il vous plaît. Je vous paye combien? Vous payez 18 cedis. So, two tins of sardines, please. How much do I pay? You pay 18 cedis. Merci. Thank you. So we are going to look at vocabularies on food items that you may want to buy. I'll read the French and you have the English aside. La banane plantain, la banane mûre, le manioc, le taro, une igname, le maïs, la farine de maïs, la farine de blé, le foutou, la bouillie de maïs, la bouillie de riz, le haricot. Please repeat after me. I continue the food items. Le bangkou, le kenke, sauce aubergine, sauce arachide, sauce graine, sauce gombo, sauce tomate. Here are other food items like fruits. Dans des fruits, on a ici des fruits, quelques aliments, une orange, la mandarine, une pomme, un ananas, la papaye, une mangue, la banane douce, le melon, une goyave, strawberry. Now for vegetables, we have the légumes, la salade, la carotte, la pomme de terre, un oignon, le piment, la tomate, une aubergine, un concombre, le haricot, un avocat. Let's look at other food items. We have la viande. On a la viande, ok? Toujours quelques aliments, la viande ou du poisson. Je vais lire, so I'm going to read, you can follow me by repeating after me. La viande de poulet, la viande de bœuf, la viande de mouton, la viande de brousse, du poisson, le tilapia, le silure, la sardine. Le poisson fumé, le poisson braisé, le poisson grillé, le saucisson, le crabe, de l'escargot. On a aussi le fromage. So we have cheese. For the cheese, we have the following in French and we have the English as I repeat after me, please. Le yaourt, le beurre, le chocolat, l'œuf. La pâtisserie, so pastries, le gâteau, le pain, le croissant, les biscuits, la tartine. Autres aliments, other food items, on a l'eau, or you can say de l'eau, le sucre, le sel, le milo, le café, le thé, le lait, le Fanta, le Coca-Cola, le malt, le vent. So here are still other kind of food. So sometimes the taste of the food, it contains sugar, it could be salty, it could be fatty and cold. So let's see how it goes in French. Aliments sucrés for sugary food, aliments salés for salty food. When there's plenty salt, we say l'aliment est salé, okay? Or le riz est salé, la nourriture est salée, le foutu est salé. So these are examples. So let's continue. Aliments gras, aliments aigres. Voilà. So still other food, we have aliments crus, which is uncooked food. Aliments cuits, cooked food. Aliments cuits à l'eau, so you use water to cook it. Aliments cuits au four, so you bake it. So aliments grillés, aliments frits. La quantité, which is the quantity. So if you go to buy food, sometimes you may want to add the quantity that you want to buy. You have the following: 1 kilo 2, okay? 1 kilo 2, again with ed apostrophe. You use the 2 when the food item starts with a consonant, and we use 1 kilo plus d apostrophe when the food item starts with a vowel like orange, okay? 1 kilo de banane douce. And then with the D apostrophe, you have 1 kilo d'orange. Okay? So now let's look at the quantity first. Une boîte de, a tin of. Une bouteille de, a bottle of. Okay, so let's go. For the food item, we have banane douce, concombre, orange, chou, salade, lait, haricots, verre, vin, huile. So you have the English aside. Un sachet de, okay, a sachet of, une boîte de, a tin of, un sac de, a bag of. Example, un sachet de lait, un sachet de Milo. You know, sometimes the milk can be in a container, a tin, it can also be in a sachet form, right? Une boîte de tomates, a tin of tomatoes. You can still have tomatoes also in a sachet form. Okay, so it all varies as to how you want to buy it. Either you want un sachet, une boîte de, or un sac de. From the quantity, you move to exercises. You go to a supermarket to buy food stuff. In a dialogue with the seller, you indicate the food item you want to buy, the quantity, and the mode of payment. Write your dialogue in French. Thank you. Merci. Et au revoir. Thank you and goodbye.